आई एम अनीता शर्मा एंड टुडे आई एम विद प्रोफेसर अंकुर जोशी एट वनस्थली विद्यापीठ. सो ही इज़ अ वेरी पॉपुलर स्कॉलर हियर इन द स्पेस ऑफ इंडियन ईथोस. सो वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू सी दैट दीज टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक्स आर वेरी लेस रिसर्च बट येट रिक्वायर्ड अ लॉट. सो आई थिंक प्रोफेसर अंकुर जोशी इज गोइंग टू टेल अस अबाउट इट एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग माई इन्विटेशन एंड योर टाइम फॉर इम्पॉर्टम. We welcome you.
Thank you so much. And it is a very interesting initiative of yours. And when I visited your website, so it was very interesting that something of this kind is being done. So it's my pleasure to be with you.
You have been very kind, so thank you so much. So in your words, what is Indian ethos?
So it is a very difficult question, because to put it into words, it's really difficult as to what can be Indian ethos in a few lines, because it is sometimes very plural, sometimes very individualistic, sometimes feel collectivistic, sometimes feels it's highly rule bound, sometimes there are no rules. When I used to visit Gurukul during my research, then some senior acharya, they told one of the interesting aspect was of acharya. But who is an acharya? So the person who delivers the education or a knowledge through acharan, that is by internalizing.
Okay.
So this is a very common phrase, that ahimsa parmo dharma, which has become very common. But the more important word or a phrase or a sukti in our scripture is achar parmo dharma. That is the acharan or the behavior, right behavior is the utmost duty that has to be followed. So if we talk about the Indian ethos, that the right acharan, that we can say, it's very difficult to find a right equivalent word in the English literature of that acharan word. So that I feel is the essence, that right acharan sums it all of Indian ethos. Everything else can follow in that sense.
Okay. So India's happiness index is going down. So do you see any relation in this ethos as well as Indian happiness, which is going down?
So yes, that there is strong relationship between the Indian ethos and happiness, because you might have heard there are three words like sukh, dukh and anand. So these three words, when looked at from a concept, so there are cases when person may be sukhi and he may be in a state of anand. He may be dukhi and he may be in a state of anand also. Like labor pain, being a any, you can ask to any lady, so labor is a labor pain, the word is a pain, but that is a state of anand sometimes. Like a girl getting married,
it's a painful situation,
painful, but they are in a state of anand. It's a moment of anand also. So this happiness words need to be redefined. Not only redefined, there's this happiness index, there are parameters which need to be relooked at. Okay. Many times, like if I ask you that are you happy, you may say yes, I am happy in general. If I give you a questionnaire on which the happiness index is based, and they ask you to respond, and based on that parameter they might conclude that you are not happy. So this happiness index is really under question. Professor Harsh Purohit, in one of his video on the SWAYAM module, he has talked about this concept also. So I will share you that video also. That the research and the parameters on which this such kind of index are developed or studies are being done.
So these are under question.
These are definitely under
so
question.
So are you trying to build something around happiness as well as Indian ethos? Working on that.
I have not.
So because you have just mentioned that there is a correlation, and we find that there is a huge scope in terms of research. If I quantify the outcomes.
Yes,
of your research. So are you into it?
As of now, I have not developed any framework or that links it with the happiness index, but it links with the overall duties and responsibilities that a person delivers. So with respect to that, I have been working, like how the social entrepreneurship is linked with this, or public policies are linked with that. So overall citizen services are linked, the experience with the education system, how it can be improved, the quality of education can be improved. So I, because my area is a little bit into that education sector, but happiness as a concept, I have not developed a research on this, but this is really under the, this concept of happiness, grassroots, from what do we call as happiness, is really need to be understood, because similar thing happens with the success parameters.
Absolutely.
Like we say in India, generally many people with the stories that we read, not just in India and abroad also, the most of the motivational or the inspirational stories that you study or read, they are highly skewed towards the professional success part of it. So a person who has been glorified as a successful person, no offense to him, they've done a great work, every story has one thing, that they sacrifice their personal life or personal aspects, and they develop professional, and society celebrates it. Equal number, in fact, in large number of people in India we have, who have very happily sacrificed their professional lives for the purpose of professional joy that they, sorry, the personal joy or the happiness that they wanted to have. Just like many many parents and the family members, they would give up their promotion so that they can stay at home. They would
not.
But
they are not considered as success stories, because
not
this is something which they are doing for themselves.
But
for the larger mass, it is not reaching.
But at the same time, we want that kind of people in our places. We were like, if a person, young generation, many people in 50s and 60s, they find that their kids have left to America or other countries, or they are living out of town, they are not living with their parents, and they try to call them, they come back, and they are said, because of the professional commitments, they cannot come. So I generally ask to those parents and teachers that when they were young, you only defined the successful parameters as those, and now that is ingrained in their mind, chitta, that we call since childhood. It has been that the successful person is one who gets professional success, who earns a lot of money. So it was since childhood that was freezed, and now that the person has achieved that, you want him to
come back,
be professionally successful, as well as want to on the personal front also.
So people doesn't understand sometimes that you can't have it all. So and you
yes.
have defined your own success.
Own success, and that ultimately you wanted the person to be personally successful also. But that definition varied, and because of it, there are many repercussions in the society. So this success, happiness, all these are.
So there's a huge scope in this in terms of research, because these things are a part of OBHR literature as well as as well as some other literature in terms of Indian management. Because these are family values which we define, that okay, child should take care of parents and also professionally succeed. So these are some challenges which kids are facing these days. I'm sure a new scope and new research domain is evolving immediately after talking to you. So I think this is something which is yet not captured, though we have talked a lot about career of a woman, and we have also talked about the dichotomy which these ladies are facing. But definitely we have not talked about such type of things which you are just mentioning.
So that
I'm sure this is a very big and wide domain to be researched.
As you might have heard, there is a word called indigenous. So in terms of the academic research, it has been defined beautifully by one of the scholars, that something which is culturally and contextually embedded. So those kind of research when which takes the cultural aspect, contextual aspect into account for doing the research, that can be more meaningful to the grassroots, and that brings to our initial part
so
of the.
So, do you have any framework around it, or a questionnaire already designed?
See, my domain of research is more of in the qualitative domain, because it's putting the human aspects into the questionnaire of Likert scales.
Yeah,
or,
that I understand. So, eventually, for the to reach to the larger data and the larger segment. Your qualitative research will lead us to get these questionnaires only.
That can be developed.
So currently you are into that qualitative setup where you are
currently,
just trying to understand the phenomena first.
Yes, and because this Likert scale which was forcefully fitted into the social science domain, because initially as my professor Rajan Gupta, he talks about the history how this quantitative research came into the social sciences, because the scientist word per se was generally used for scholars in the physical sciences domains, physics, chemistry, electronics. But when the social, the people who used to do social studies, they were not called scientists. So this, because your methodology is not robust, you don't have any substantial. So this quantification of the social science domain started from there. But that is sometimes very inhuman. Suppose if I ask, are you happy? You say, I am very happy. I say, how much happy you are? So, I am very happy.
We can't calculate. We can't
then,
measure
then
it.
I will come with a questionnaire. No. Don't answer. I say, I am just happy. Answer on a Likert scale. If you are sad, very sad 1, sad 2, neutral 3, 4, whatever. So that tries to...
So emotions cannot be captured.
They are captured, but there is something that gets lost in the this quantification, just like in analog and discrete. In the analog, there is a flow. When we try to discrete, however perfect it may be, there is some part of data being lost. So, I am not against the quantitative research, but as of now, I don't feel very much connected with the quantitative research
idea.
There are many sectors in which quantitative research is very useful, but some when we want to take a decision based on the large part or a breadth of a research, it's very useful. But this subtle aspects of human nature, they are, as I told in the initial, but the Indian ethos, it is very sometimes very plural, very individualistic. Sometimes it goes very collective. So sometimes I feel okay in this part quantitative research is useful, but sometimes it cannot be captured. Hardly, very difficult to capture in the words itself from the qualitative domain. So, quantitative is so far in that terms.
Absolutely, yes. I understand. So, research is a very isolated journey. So, what keeps you motivated? And that too in a space which is very less people are working.
So, this is one of the personal satisfaction that is these Indian ethos, ideas and this thing. My linkage with that is largely with the education sector. So since my engineering days, like when I was in the second year and third year of my engineering, this quality improvement in the education was my focus areas. And while doing engineering also, I used to wonder how the quality of education in our country can be improved. And linkage with the Bharati culture, that so the education and Bharati culture and the impact that it can bring to the lives of people in our country. It can do justice with our generations and generation of people who have sacrificed so much.
So this is the broader agenda you have.
This is the broader thing that agenda and that the point that you asked about what keeps motivated. So this keeps me motivated that it is our duty that what our generations and ancestors have preserved for us, which needs to be sustained by us. So this, when we talk about culture, we see that many a times this museum culture is getting into our everything. We want to keep it preserved somewhere in the box, but culture is something which can be preserved only by living it. So that is the linkage, education and our culture. So this keeps on motivating, and the more and more it gets reinforced every day by looking the things that are happening around us. So all things boil down that there is something that deviation from our traditional culture and the education system, which is resulting into one or the problem every day. So that is.
So that motivates you a lot.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Ankur ji.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.